My vision for myself is to be the greatest martial artist to ever live. I started in mixed martial arts at age 19. From my very first fight, commentators were saying, man, this guy reminds me a lot of Anderson Silva. So I put a lot of pressure on myself from day one to compete at the absolute highest level and to be the best, you know, to perform in a spectacular fashion. So every one of my fights since age 23 has been against the number one contender, and it's been a lot for me to juggle. You know, I think I focus so much on being the best as a martial artist, I let my character slide. Getting away from the sport for a year, I had time to just develop my character. I really got an opportunity to understand how much of a special thing it is to be the best in the world at something, how rare it is. And I really got an opportunity to see clearly how I was pissing it all away. So having this time away has really just developed me as a person, and ultimately that relates to me as an athlete. I feel like I'm at the top of my game as an athlete and as an individual. I'm proud of myself and where I'm at right now, for sure. I appreciate Daniel being here, Gustafson being here, Anthony Johnson being here. You know, without these guys, you know, there's no competition for me. There's, you know, I look at them this way. I got three guys to work harder than. I got three guys to be more focused than, to love this sport more than. These are the only three guys that can stop me from going down as one of the greatest of all time. And none of them are gonna stop me. None of them are gonna stop me. None of them are gonna stop me. I study everybody extensively, and then I come up with their patterns. I figure out the way they flinch. I figure out their first favorite punch, their second favorite punch, their third, their favorite combinations, their setups to their takedowns, when they clinch, what side of their head's going to be on. Literally everything. I know everything about every opponent. I have a lot of pride in my work ethic. I've been skinny my whole career, whooping people's ass. I'm not a knockout artist. I win because I'm smart. And, you know, I work hard. I believed in myself wholeheartedly from day one, and I made sure that all those kids that I was looking in the eyes, telling them that I wanted to be a UFC fighter, and the ones that doubted me or looked at me funny, I made sure that I would prove them wrong one day. And now I think I'm the one of the biggest prize in my hometown. There's been a lot of athletes who get all this accolade and people telling them that they're the greatest and they're the next Muhammad Ali and all this type of stuff. And then they start believing it, and they stop training, and they start treating people differently, and they become someone different than the person they were at the beginning.
I went through this huge spiritual thing where I became obsessed with the power of the mind, and I got into a deep, like really deep, just meditation, visualization, and just realizing how powerful our minds actually are, like how we really do paint our world with our thoughts and our level of self-belief. What I really need is to know that I'm changing lives. Like, that motivates me more than anything else right now. I feel like I'm in a position to really touch a lot of people and inspire a lot of people because of where I came from. Doing it for other people motivates me probably more than doing it for myself.